Dr. Rajesh Jain is a joint MD of Panacea Biotech India. I invite him onto the dais. Mr. K.V. Balasubramaniam, MD, Indian Immunologicals Limited. Dr. P.V. Appaji Garu, ED of the Pharmaxil. And Dr. Kuppuswamy, MD and CEO, Tergene Biotech. I was told that I should give few opening remarks, after which I will request Dr. Rajesh Jain to make a presentation. He is an expert in this area. We should be able to utilize his expertise, and he would give an insight. Like a typical bureaucrat, I will be very superficial on this issue. The issue has been flagged in the brochure that the entry into the regulated markets is an issue for this country, and some of the companies were able to really get in to highly regulated markets. They were able to break through, but certainly we have several issues and problems in this. But I would like to give this brief opening remarks, trying to give the status on this. We all know that a few decades ago, vaccine segment was treated as a very low profit oriented area, and there were very few companies into this. But keeping in view the requirements of the developing countries and the health care scenario, there was a kind of a, what industry terms is a virtual renaissance into this area. So world over, the vaccine sales increased from $10 billion, jumped to $28 billion in 2010. And at the same time, the growth in the biopharma in the country took place, and we have specialized locations in the country where very focused cluster-based growth took place. And as the Indian industry grew, we also saw consolidation, where Pfizer taking over Wyeth and Merck acquiring Schering, and Sanofi taking over Shanta Biotech. But initially, we were, before the Renaissance, it was mainly focused on pediatric vaccine industry. But today, we have grown wider, and there's a lot of R&D going into this, and a wider area of health issues and combination of vaccines we are going ahead. But still, the pediatric proprietary segment is 27% of the market in 2009. Now it is increased to 32%. It is likely to increase 32% in 2015. Seasonal flu vaccine accounted for $5 billion in 2010, and for which over 70% being accounted by USA, Japan, France, Germany, Italy, Spain, and UK, and it is expected to touch $7 million by 2016. And hepatitis B vaccine is the next largest subsegment that we are looking at it. And we all know that the five top vaccine manufacturers globally, GSK, Sanofi, Pfizer, Novartis, and Merck. And these top is $2.4 billion. Proquad for measles, mumps, $1.38 billion. Gardasil of human papilloma virus is about $1.35 billion. Prevnar 7 for, again, Streptococcus pneumonia is $1.2 billion. And GSK hepatitis infractrix for hepatitis A and B is also 1.2. And for flu zone influenza, it's about $1.2 billion. So again, the market for meningitis and rotavirus vaccine is crossed in US $1 billion 2009. So I'm trying to highlight this because the regulated markets are very important for us. We need to reach them, and how our R&D would be focused and how we'll be able to break through, not only the major companies, the medium level companies, even smaller companies, whether they'll be able to enter these regulatory markets, what are the problems we are facing in that area. And of course, we have US is expected to be the leader, followed by Europe. But we hope the Indian export in vaccines, which are at around $194 million US dollars in 2011, will come up in a big way and take this country ahead, we would have the benefit of the expertise sitting on the dais, and I hand over it to Dr. Rajesh Jain. Thank you.
Thanks, Dr. Rajshekar. Good afternoon, everybody. It's indeed a very relevant and important subject for India, for the vaccine industry in India, especially for the export, especially as an export opportunity for all of us. The last decade in India has seen a lot of vaccine manufacturers from India participating not only in supporting the government of India's mission of immunization, of universal immunization program, but also contributing to WHO and UNICEF and several other organizations like Gavi and Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation in furthering their objectives of actually making vaccines available to masses at affordable cost, a good quality vaccine at affordable cost, in fact. So therefore, this issue becomes of very vital importance to new startup companies which are looking at now biotechnology as their venture of investment. Up to now, biotechnology has been considered as a field for generally children or infants or the newborns. But the 21st century will see a huge change as we move forward year by year. And I'm going to take this opportunity to actually walk you through a glimpse of global opportunity that lies ahead of us, the market potential, both in terms of volume and value, although a lot of products which are driving present growth has been discussed by Dr. Rajshekar. However, I will tell you a different glimpse of in vaccine world, how do we really determine the size and what are the key drivers? And then I would want to touch base upon what advantage India offers, and within that, the challenges that lie and the possible solutions. In challenges and solutions, I have focused a part of the presentation only on small and startup companies, but the challenges and solutions for bigger companies in India, which are now shaping up the whole vaccine industry, are very different, and obviously I will give a reference to that also. In 2007, the vaccine industry globally was around $20 billion, and we expected that by 2023, this will go up to almost $97 billion, that is five times the growth, and exactly it is happening in a similar manner. The cost effectiveness of vaccine in combating diseases is becoming far more important now, especially in the developing world, which I will touch base upon subsequently and I'll tell you the rationale behind that. There is a greater appetite for vaccines from government in this period of forecast, which is now from 2012 to 2023, which is almost 11 years. And industry has to respond with innovative vaccines, technological advances in genetics and immunology, and then launch of newer vaccines for prevention and treatment of range of diseases. Why I say this is of particular importance, because the growth will not come from generalization of vaccines for the developing world. The growth will come from innovative and new vaccines, because this is where I believe the larger market size in the developed world lies, the ICH region. And all those vaccines which are already available for the last 20, 30 years will now be needed in mass for the developing world. And this is where cost advantage will be of key importance when it has to reach the masses. As I said, up to now, we have seen that vaccines have been reserved essentially for It has been seen as a market for only pediatric and in newborn infants. But as we move forward, you would see that vaccines will become the laser part. Okay, thanks. Vaccines will become of crucial importance for almost all age groups in the next 10 years, right from infants and children to adolescents, adults and elderly.